A fear of flying is a very common yet very treatable condition. It can be caused by a bad experience on board a plane, such as encountering severe turbulence while flying, or even worst case scenarios like abnormal operation while on board, such as an engine failure or an emergency landing. But really, most commonly, what a fearful flyer is afraid of while flying is simply the way that their fear and anxiety makes them feel. Now take a look at this picture. If you have a fear of flying, this picture alone may give you anxiety. You know, the fear of flying is one of the most common phobias. It can be very difficult to overcome because you have all these fear factors coming into play simultaneously. You may feel claustrophobic while flying. You know, heaven forbid you're in the middle seat. You may fear being trapped in the plane. You may have anxiety about the possibility of having a panic attack while on board, or you may just fear crashing. And some of your fears may have no bias in reality at all, and they're simply just the result of myths that you have wrongly come to believe as fact. So this video is going to clear up three major myths about flying that lead many people astray. And once you learn that these myths are nothing but falsities, you can easily just kind of throw them out the window and put yourself at ease, that they have no bearing on your flight experience, and certainly not your safety during the flight. So let's talk about the first myth right now, which is air pockets. Now, very commonly, those who fear flying will be concerned about air pockets. And I have news for you. Air pockets are about as real as the tooth fairy. Now, this myth is that if a plane is unlucky enough to fly through one of these mythical air pockets, it can suddenly fall hundreds of feet, and this simply is not true. There's no place in the sky that is a pocket without air. Now, I'm sure you've never been walking down the street and suddenly you couldn't breathe because you walked into an air pocket. I know the analogy isn't the best, but you know, the fact is the notion is absurd. And air pockets don't exist. A second big myth is that planes are fragile, and that, you know, turbulence can actually cause great damage and is a threat to the safety of passengers and crew, or, you know, turbulence can even break the wings of the plane. And this is completely false. In reality, commercial planes are meant to withstand far more turbulence than you would ever experience on a normal flight, and no amount of turbulence you would typically encounter can damage the plane at all, much less break the wings. Turbulence is far more of an annoyance than a danger, and the plane's strength is really in its flexibility. The wings of an airplane are actually extremely pliable, and they can bend and flex with the airplane, you know, just like a blade of grass can gently bend while, you know, an inflexible oak tree, you know, in a terrible storm, might break and topple. It's this flexibility that actually gives the airplane its strength. You should know the bottom line of this is that turbulence is a comfort issue, not a safety issue, and planes are not fragile at all. Another pervasive myth, whose origin is one of misunderstanding, is that a plane will tumble out of the sky if the engines quit working. And in reality, even without engines, a plane can glide for a very long time, up to 100 miles from cruise altitude, just like a paper airplane. Planes simply don't fall. In fact, gliding without engine power on landing, it's quite common in order to save fuel. So, if you're afraid that your airplane is going to just fall from the sky, you can put that worry behind you. It simply isn't possible. And, you know, aside from that, you know, just the idea of engine failure itself can really strike fear into a passenger. But the fact is, most commercial airplanes are built with redundant engines, at least two major engines. And jumbo airplanes, you know, are built with at least four. So, there is redundancy built into the engines, but like I said, once you're at cruise altitude, even if an engine failed, you can still cruise for about 100 miles, you know, into a safe landing. So listen, this is really just the tip of the iceberg. There are many, many more myths about flying that can cause unnecessary fear and anxiety. We've really only scratched the surface here. And the more information you have about flight and how planes work, the less you're really going to be afraid. So I highly recommend you get the popular free report on the Takeoff Today website through the link right below. And there you can learn exactly what enables a plane to fly safely. And it's going to allow you to put many of your fears behind you. Once you understand the mechanics of a plane, you can really rationalize the whole flight process. So go ahead and click the link below, download the free report right now on the Takeoff Today website, and alleviate your fear of flying. It's really going to help you out a lot. That's it for today. Take care. Bye-bye.